greet you in the most wonderful and precious name of our soon coming King, the Lord and Savior Jesus Christ, He who was and is to come. Amen. Amen. We have so much to give God praise for. Praise the Lord. God has been good to us. Amen. Yes. Praise the Lord. And we praise the name of the Lord. Hallelujah. Know that that which God has started in us, we know that He is well able. He's abundantly able to complete it. He's abundantly able to finish it. Praise the name of the Lord. Praise the Lord. All that God wants us to do is to learn how to trust Him. He just wants us to learn how to trust Him, to hold on to His unchanging hands and don't let Him go. Amen. Amen. Praise the Lord. Bless the Lord. Praise the Lord. Believers, you know, I just want to encourage you again this morning, because we are living in a time, you know, when the world is changing, and the world is changing significantly. And I want you to know that the world, or the changes that has taken place in the world, it is not by chance. Amen. It is in accordance to God's plan and God's purpose for this time. Amen. Amen. And what we can see, the changes that has taken place, they are telling us that the Lord and Savior Jesus Christ is about to burst the cloud and come back in this place. Amen. And we know the reason for Him coming. He's coming to take His church, praise the name of the Lord, with Him, and bring them back with Him, praise the name of the Lord, to judge this world. Amen. But I want you to know that as Christians, you know, on last week, Sunday, I would have started a discussion with you. And what was that discussion we looked at on last week? We looked at the mark of a Christian. Amen. And we would have looked at worship on last week. Praise the name of the Lord. I just want to, you know, talk to you shortly, just for a few minutes, about honor this week. Amen. Praise the name of the Lord. Last week, we discussed worship as the mark of a Christian. But we would like to look at honor this morning. Praise the name of the Lord. And, you know, praise the name of the Lord. And that word honor there, it simply means to respect, to esteem. It means to respect, it means to esteem. Praise the name of the Lord. And the honor there, praise the name of the Lord, the honor that I'm speaking about honoring God, giving God respect for who He is. And I'm also giving Him, praise the name of the Lord, esteem, or esteeming God highly. And esteeming God highly, praise the name of the Lord, the highest esteem that we can give to God, it is abiding in the Word of God. Amen. That our lives are being fashioned in accordance to the Word of God. Praise the Lord. And this morning, praise the name of the Lord, hallelujah. Shortly, I just want to talk to you about double longing. And I'm saying double longing. Praise the name of the Lord. And what does double longing mean? It means, praise the name of the Lord, and desiring or having the desire, praise the name of the Lord, for two things that is conflicting one to the other. Amen. So I'm talking about double longing. Praise the name of the Lord. And you know, praise the name of the Lord. And when we speak about honor, you know, Exodus chapter 20 and verse 7, Exodus 20 and verse 7, the Bible reads here, "Thou shalt not take the name of the Lord thy God in vain, for the Lord will not hold him guiltless that taketh his name in vain." Praise the name of the Lord. And what you're seeing, now that is happening, praise the name of the Lord, and among Christians throughout the world, it is, praise the name of the Lord. And a lot of folks, praise the name of the Lord, is testifying that God told me and God gave me directions. And you see even what happened in the United States for last week, praise the name of the Lord. My God, a lot of these people believe that they have directions from God. And praise the name of the Lord, but praise the name of the Lord. A lot of people believe to themselves, praise the name of the Lord. And my God, they went out there, and they went out there in the name of the Lord. Amen. Praise the Lord. But as we read there just now, hallelujah, you know, in Exodus, there Moses is saying, thou shalt not take the name, and God, praise the name of the Lord, is speaking to his prophet, thou shalt not take the name of the Lord thy God in vain. In vain. For the Lord will not hold him that do so guiltless, that taketh his name in vain. Praise the name of the Lord. This morning, as I speak to you shortly about double longing, praise the name of the Lord. Double longing. And if you look at 1 John chapter 2 and verses 4, 1 John chapter 2 and verses 4, praise the name of the Lord. The Bible reads there, he that said, I know him, praise the name of the Lord. That is in First John chapter 2 and verses 4. The Bible reads, he that said, I know him, and keepeth not his commandments, is a liar, and the truth is not in him. Praise the name of the Lord. So we are talking about double longing here. Praise the name of the Lord. You are saying one thing, but doing something else. Praise the name of the Lord. So that is what double longing, praise the name of the Lord, is also all about. And I want you to understand, praise the Lord, as we continue to observe in the time that we are living in, which we call the last days, what you will see is the love of double longing. Praise the name of the Lord. He that said, I know him, and keepeth not his commandments, is a liar, and the truth is not in him. Praise the name of the Lord. You'll see, praise the name of the Lord, double longing also, it is a desire for God and a desire for God and sin both. Praise the name of the Lord. Or both God and sin. Praise the name of the Lord. And I want you to understand, folks, it is useless that preachers come and preach the word of God and censor the word of God and take out certain things because you believe that people will not feel comfortable or that people will be hurt. And my God, and help these people on their way to hell. Come on, somebody. Preachers, praise the name of the Lord, ought to teach people, praise the Lord. And my God, a double longing or desire for God and sin at the same time, praise the name of the Lord, it is not according to the will of God. Amen. You see, my God, I'm not talking about temptation here. Temptation is not sin. Amen. Temptation is not sin. What is sin? It is when we know that something is wrong. It is not according to God's will and we are practicing it. Somebody, I want you to understand, listen to me, my God. Life and death. You know, we always say that there is a thin line between sanity and insanity. Amen. It is the same way there is a very thin line between life and death. You see, you can be walking and living in sin. When I say sin, let me explain. My God, sin is a transgression against the laws of God. So you can be living and walking, transgressing the laws of God now and believing that you will go to heaven because you believe that you have a chance. You believe that you can still make things right with God. But you know what? You don't know when you will die. Amen. You don't know the minute nor the hour. We don't know the minute nor the hour. You can fall down and with a heart attack and you can die today. Now, that moment of your death will determine where you go. Praise the name of the Lord. So it's a very thin line between life and death. And I'm going to say life and death. I'm not just talking about the bread that we breathe and losing the bread that we breathe. But I'm talking about being able to live with God forever or live in hell forever. Praise the name of the Lord. So somebody, praise the name of the Lord, my God. Desiring in Matthew 6 and verses 24, Jesus said in Matthew 6 and verses 24, praise the name of the Lord, I'm going on. He said, no man can serve two masters. Matthew chapter 6 and verses 24. Jesus said, no man can serve two masters. For either he will hate the one and love the other, or else he will hold to the one and despise the other. You cannot serve God and the devil and mammon at the same time. Amen. You cannot serve God. You have to choose one. Amen. You have to marry God. You have to make up your mind. I'm ready to live for eternity where worms don't die. I'm ready to live for eternity where the fire don't quench. I'm ready to live in for eternity in eternal hell and torture and pains for eternity. You have to make up your mind. If you want that, or you want to live in eternal bliss and happiness and joy, praise the name of the Lord, in the presence of the Lord, praise the Lord. But my God, we cannot have double longings, praise the name of the Lord. Believers, I hear me. And I want you to understand it is time, the time is now for preachers to preach the word of God. It's a waste of time standing on the altar and my God and compromising, praise the name of the Lord, the will of God and helping people to go to hell. And my God, and you believe that you're serving the purpose that God is calling to serve. Amen. Then my God, it's better to stay home and lie down on your bed and get ready to go to hell like everybody else. Amen. Somebody, are you listening to me? You see, my God, double longing, hallelujah, design, praise the name of the Lord, for God and the world at the same time, having both. Design to have God and to have the world. What do we mean by that? If you look at 1 John, praise the name of the Lord, 1 John chapter 2, verses 15 and 17, 1 John chapter 2, verses 15 and 17, praise the Lord, the Bible reads there, love not the world. 1 John chapter 2, verses 15 and 17. The Bible reads, love not the world, neither the things that are in the world. If any man love the world, the love of the Father is not in him. For all that is in the world, the lust of the flesh, and the lust of the eyes, and the pride of life, and it is not of who? Of the Father. But it is of the world. And the world, what will happen to the world? The world passeth away and the lust thereof. But he that doeth the will of the Father abideth for how long? Abideth forever. So desire to have God and to have the world. And that is another problem. We are so taken up in the systems of the world. When I say the systems of the world, it is okay, my God, to be blessed. It is okay to want to have a bigger house and a beautiful car. Praise the name. It is okay to want to have a lot of money in the bank. Praise the name of the Lord. It is okay because money answers all things. Amen. But I want you to understand, my God, you don't ever put these things before God. Amen. My God, you ought to understand that even money itself, the Bible teaches that the love of money, it becomes the root of all evil. Amen. When a man loves money, when a man loves money, I want you to understand, listen to it. He is going to not only die for it, because we see so many young men losing their life because of money, praise the name of the Lord, but he will also take another man's life for it, praise the Lord. I want you to understand, praise the name of the Lord, what the judge is saying here. Judge said, we ought not, he said, love not the world. What is the world? And the Bible says, and judge said in there, pray, all that are in the world is the loss of the flesh, and the loss of the eyes, and the pride of life. The loss of the flesh, the loss of the eyes, and the pride of life. I want you to understand, it is not difficult, it is not hard to live a Christian life, praise the Lord. All that a Christian life calls for, it is applying the will of God to your life, praise the Lord. It is applying the will of God to your life. That is all a Christian life calls for, praise the name of the Lord. So desire to have the world. God don't want us to have that double longing, want to have him and have the world. It's either you have the world or you have God. Amen. You see, we live in the world and we're part of the world. Jesus said, Father, I am not asking you to take them out of the world. Praise the name of the Lord. I don't want you to take them out. We live here. Come on, somebody. And while you live here, enjoy the best of it. Amen. My God, if you could have all the convenience, have all the convenience. Put a pool in your yard. My God, if you could put a pool on top of your house, put it there too. Because, my God, you are blessed. You are the children of the Most High, and we bless you. Amen. Praise the name of the Lord. Be rich and my God, hallelujah. But I want you to understand, hallelujah, you have to make sure in all things God first. Amen. Praise the name of the Lord. Praise the Lord. Desire for sinful friends. Praise the name of the Lord. A desire for sinful friends and also Christian friends at the same time. And I want to praise the name of the Lord. Now, I have to be careful with that. Because praise the name, I have to be very careful with that one. But let us look at 2 Corinthians 6 and verse 17. You know, and Paul said there, and that is a scripture that when you really think on it, it makes it send you all over the place. But Paul said it, wherefore come out from where? Second Corinthians chapter 6 and verse 17. I hope I give you the right scripture there. 2 Corinthians chapter 6 and verse 17. That is what I have noted here. Praise and verse 17. Paul said, wherefore come out from where? Among them and be ye what? Separated, say the Lord. And touch not the what? The unclean things, and I will do what? And I will do what? And I will receive you. I want you to understand, listen, you can have a lot of people in your life, but some of the people that you will have in your life, I want you to understand, some of the people, not all the people as a Christian that you will have in your life, who you deal with on a daily basis, maybe, my God, maybe good friends to keep. Amen. I'm going to say good friends to keep. Praise the name of the Lord. My God, some of them might be very good colleagues. Praise the name of the Lord. They might be very good colleagues, but they are not really good friends. And let me tell you, praise the name of the Lord. A friend, praise the name of the Lord, it is one who you can follow. A friend is one who you can take example from. Praise the name of the Lord. A friend is one who will lead you down the path of righteousness. Amen. And if a person is in your life, the person might be a very nice person, a very nice human being. We work together. We are very, my God, we are colleagues. Praise the name of the Lord. I meet with you and we line sometimes. But when we sit up to line, praise the name of the Lord, you have a direction that you are going with in your life. And I know the direction that I have to go in my life. Amen. So my God, if you tell me, we sit down and you tell me, you know something, I'm going and buy a rounds of beer. And my God, and I said, because I have you to be my friend, I said, it's okay for you to buy the rounds of beer. I may only use one. I want you to understand, my God, that I am going in your direction. But my God, I must take the lead because you are my colleague and I want you to become my friend. You will only become my friend when you begin to go the direction that God wants all of us to go. Amen. Because he made us to know him, to love him, and to serve him. Amen. If what you are doing, whatsoever you are doing, and it is not according to the will of God, you are not a friend. And the Bible says, my God, come out from among them. Amen. Come out from among them and praise the name of the Lord and touch not the unclean thing. What is the unclean thing? Praise the name of the Lord. Touch not the unclean thing. Touch not the unclean thing. And I want you to understand when you look up, my God, touching the unclean thing. Anything that is not according to the will of God is unclean. Amen. Anything that is not in accordance to the will of God, it is unclean. Anything that is not in accordance to the will of God is unclean. Now I want you to understand, you know, at one time, and I want to be, my God, just give you a little example. Moses, you know, would have sent out men to spy the land and that sort of thing. And the Bible said that some bring back good report and some bring back what? Evil report. And evil report there, it was not according to the will of God. And why was it according to the will of God? Because they were seeing giants and giants could eat. And they were like grasshopper, and the giants were so big they could kill them and that sort of thing. But that is not what God wants us to see things. Amen. We must always see giants as bread. Amen. And we can eat them up. Amen. Praise the Lord. So if you have someone that is speaking that kind of negative into your life, that my God, things is not working for you. Things will not work for you. I don't know how you will make it through that the year 2021. Look how difficult things was for you. Your children may not be able to, I don't think your children will be as successful. successful as you say they will be able, because this didn't happen, that didn't happen. And I want you to understand, listen, those are evil reports, amen. Amen. My God, such a person come out from among them, amen. Because the only thing they will do is contaminate you and cause you to lack faith. And my God, hallelujah, I will walk, my God, in doubt and not in faith. Amen. Praise the name of the Lord. My God, desiring with sinful friends, as I said, and praise the name of God. Desiring for God and pleasure at the same time. God and pleasure at the same time. 1 Timothy 5 and verses 6. 1 Timothy 5 and verses 6. And that is another problem. My God, we have believers, my God. Every they go good from January. They go good from March to December. And my God, at the moment carnivals come around, they start to they feel, my God, I just can't stay easy. The pets begin to call them, praise them, pleasure. And I want you to understand, when I say pleasure, I want you to know that the Bible teaches, my God, in the presence of the Lord is fullness of joy, and his right hand there is what? Pleasure forevermore. My God, you can have pleasure in Christ. Amen. But you know, it is 1 Timothy 25 and verse 6. But she that liveth in pleasure is dead while she liveth. Amen. She that liveth in pleasure. And living in pleasure, they don't mean that in effect every day. Living in pleasure don't mean that in effect and all the different fet, you know what I say. It don't mean, listen, all that don't have cannibal, you can be still living in the pleasure that's in your mind. Look at what the Bible said. The Bible said it. But she that liveth in pleasure, she that liveth in pleasure means that person, pleasure, the pleasure, praise that the desire, whatever their desire, is always there. Amen. So my God, when the lion and the sleep, all that is seen is bungee. They're not seeing Jesus. And my God, when the lion and the sleep, they're seeing Marshall Montana. They're not seeing Jesus, because my God, it's fed season. And right now, some of them don't even care about COVID-19. COVID-19 is not important to them, because it's fed season. Let me fed and then die. As long as I fed. And that is what my God. So desire to have God and pleasure at the same time. I think we touched that scripture already. 1 Timothy chapter 5, verse 6. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. Bless the Lord. Praise the name of the Lord. Our very language. Praise the Lord. We can be doubling our language. Our language must be for God. Praise the name of the Lord. If we look at Isaiah, and this is my last scripture because of time. Isaiah, praise the name of the Lord. I want to really should praise the name of the Lord. Shortly, I have to go and also pick up my youths because their car is down to bring them up to church. Praise the name of the Lord. Isaiah 4 verses, Isaiah 42 verses 1 to 2. That is, bring them up to the other service. Praise the name of the Lord. Bless the Lord. And Isaiah 42, verses 1 and 2. The Bible reads, and behold my servant who I uphold, my elect, in whom my soul delighted. I put my spirit upon him. He shall bring forth judgment to the Gentiles. He shall not cry, nor lift up, nor cause his voice to be heard in the streets. And they praise the name of the Lord. Now Isaiah would have been talking about the Lord and Savior Jesus Christ here. But what we are seeing here, praise the name of the Lord, he was speaking about a single language and not a double language. Praise the name of the Lord. Hearing his voice in the street, it simply means there, praise the name of the Lord, my God. Our voice must be used, praise the name of the Lord, to speak the word of God and the things of God. Amen. And if, my God, if our voice is being used for anything else, then we are not, my God, using our voices for the will of God. Amen. You know, Matthew chapter 5 and verses 6, Matthew 5 and verse 6, Jesus said there in Matthew 5 and verse 6, he said, blessed are they which do hunger and thirst after righteousness, for they shall be filled. Praise the name of the Lord. And being hungering and thirsting after righteousness, you know, what my God, hallelujah, what when a man speaks, it comes from the heart. Praise the name of the Lord. And the more you feel in righteousness, you're going to speak righteousness. Amen. The more you feel in righteousness, you cannot speak anything else. Because of the Lord, my God, only righteousness will come out of your mouth. Amen. Praise the name of the Lord. So also double language. Oh, we ought to let our language be longing for God. Praise the name of the Lord. And if your language is longing for God and you're being filled with the word of God, you don't need to worry. Praise the name of the Lord about the rest. Amen. This morning I want to pause here and praise the name of the Lord. I would like to pause and I would like to stand your feet because praise the name of God.